Hey, welcome back to the channel. Larry coming to you from beautiful Rio de Janeiro. You'll have to excuse right up front, there'll be a little bit of background noise. I'm on the ocean here and it is very turbulent today after a very hot week. But hey, I'm not the weatherman. We're here to listen to some good music, get a take on it, some interpretation, a little bit of reaction and analysis. Does that sound good to you? Sounds good to me because I'm going to be playing a song uninterrupted all the way through and giving you my interpretations of what that song means. And we're going to do the logical song from Breakfast of America. This is an album I grew up with, but I hadn't really paid much attention to it in the last several years. So let's give it a new listen and stay tuned for the end of the song. I'll see if I can figure out what this song is about. That's always the challenge, by the way, on this channel. I go in blind, and that's part of the feature or value proposition of this channel. I haven't heard this song probably in 25 years, I'm guessing, more or less. And so it'll be very interesting to see what the take is now. And I'm going to listen carefully to the wording, but of course the musical arrangement as well. Without further ado, let's proceed. Could be modern day. Thank you. Wow. You know, it's as good today as it ever sounded in the past. I remember I used to love this album, like, viciously love the album. Okay. have to work on writing some scripts for these. Okay, so really good song, really fantastic. The whole arrangement sounds great. The post-production, excellently done. All the sound quality of the song is wonderful. The instrumentation is spot on. There's nice transitions in the song, starting from a little bit of synthesizer at the beginning, and then it just kind of grew into the songs, and then the drums and the rest of the instruments came in, and it turned into a song. Like, it turned into a pretty, you know, nice rhythmic song with a little bit of bounce to it. Okay, so I'd say, you know, from an instrumentation and singing point of view, and that point where I'm guessing it's Roger Hodgson. I've been corrected on this channel with Supertramp a few times before, but I'm guessing that's Roger Hodgson because it's Roger Hodgson. Yeah, Roger Hodgson. Yeah, I was thinking Roger. Why? I was confused. Okay, so. But I think he was kind of the chieftain of this Breakfast in America and Beyond type of part of Supertramp's journey. Okay, so what is the song about? You know, I never picked this up before, but obviously it's it's the story of a young man, okay, who grows up in very simple, beautiful times and thinks that life is all roses. I think I can't remember the word specifically, but you can hear at the very beginning, life is so magical, beautiful, wonderful, and all this kind of stuff, right? So, you know, you're not tainted yet. You're not, you know, what I think comes later in the song. I'll get to that in a second. So as the song flows on and it goes from verse to chorus, the next verse is really, you know, then they sent me away. And what does that mean? My best guess is he went to some kind of boarding school or some kind of university where the school system definitely let this character down. Whether it's an autobiography about the lyricist and the writer, I don't know, but definitely the character of the song, you know, all of a sudden went into like higher education perhaps and started to be programmed to be logical and cynical. It's a logical song, right? It makes sense. So, you know, the cynicism kind of creeps in, and then, you know, they'll be calling you a radical and all that kind of stuff. So it seems like the education kind of replaced this innocent, beautiful life that was predating that education. I think it's the education, so I'm pretty sure of it. And so then afterwards, as, you know, the chorus came back in, and then I think the final verse really had to do with, you know, what was the meaning of that? And you know, life used to be so wonderful, and to me it was just kind of like, you know, starting life, and I think we've all been there, you know, very relatable song, because we start with such an innocence and such a beautiful mind, a curious mind, and all these characteristics that we wish we still had close to our heart today as adults. And this song really painted that picture really well, that, you know, through education and work and further on in your life, you just become this kind of robotron, you know, that's kind of like, you know, sort of Orwellian in a sense. I mean, maybe not that extreme, but, you know, like they're going to teach you how to think, how to perform, and how to, you know, do your duty, so to speak, through life. And it's kind of like the loss of innocence and the loss of you know, all that was beautiful in the beginning, and that now that character has become logical, practical, and cynical, you know. And wow, I think, you know, for a song that's so old, I mean, I remember being a teenager, that was like 30 years ago, so I would suspect that you could re-release the song today and it would have the same effect. The same message is true today. It really is. Because all the, you know, here, look, I'm in South America. I live in Canada. I'm a Canadian. But, you know, I see it, especially when I'm in Vancouver, Canada. But, you know, I see that all the cynicism and all the divisiveness and all this kind of, you know, the school system's really programming kids and indoctrinating them. You could release this song again today and it's completely as relevant as it was when it was released, probably in the 70s, I'm guessing. Now, I got to score this song. Okay, I can't let personal sentiment get too much, you know, into the bias here, I'm going to give it a solid A, but it's a high A, okay? And it stirs up the emotions. It's a beautiful song. The lyricism, the instrumentation all flows very well. The post-production of the song is really well done, well-produced song all in all. So definitely a solid high A. So thanks for being with me today, and peace and tranquility for all of you, no matter where you're watching from. Ciao.